Good morning to all of you and welcome back to day 5 of the synchronous remote classroom mode in this workshop, QEEE workshop on pedagogy for effective use of ICT in engineering education. I hope all of you are now recharged after yesterday's session on wikis and the lab on wikis. You also, there was also a long session on how students can use different ICT tools in your classes, how you can give them assignments and activities in various Bloom's levels using technology tools. So that was what we did yesterday. Here today what we'll do is really put all of it together into what we call as a lesson plan. This is just a brief overview of what you've done all these days. I think we've gone through these points so many times now in the last couple of days and just now. It should be familiar. I'll just leave this up here for you to read for a moment. This is an important slide, especially for this session on lesson planning, because what you will do in the lesson plan is actually put all of this together. We started with learning objectives, we wrote assessment questions and aligned to higher order objectives. So that's going to be part of the lesson plan. You created activities, I'm going back and forth. You created several activities in the online phase. Think, pair, share, peer instruction, activities using visualizations, activities for flipped classroom. Those will be there in your lesson plan. You use technology and you have to somehow include some details about which technology tools you'll use in your lesson plan. And yesterday you did a peer review of all these activities, yesterday morning. And what you tried to do there is check that all these previous pieces, objectives, assessment, tools and all, are aligned with each other, that there's a match. And by now I think you're all very convinced that if there's a mismatch between the objectives and the assessment or between the activities and the objectives, then it's not a desirable situation, because the main problem that happens there is that students don't learn the way we expect them to learn. They may get unhappy about what is going on, and at the end the teacher is not happy, the students are not happy. So it's really in our best interest to avoid this mismatch between the objectives, assessment and activities. So that actually brings us to this session of lesson planning, where, as I said, you'll use all of these aspects. You will check, do one quick check that they're aligned, and you will integrate them, synthesize them, put them together into a lesson plan. So there are two words we'll just look at briefly and then you can start the activity. The first is lesson plan and the second is integrate. So if you look at the concept of lesson plan, all of you I'm sure are familiar with this concept, and many of you will also be familiar with this term. All of you do lesson planning in your daily teaching, even if you don't know this term. And in a very simple manner, using a very simple definition, a lesson plan is a description of the plan of instruction for one class. What details to put in that plan is something we'll discuss in a moment. But the description, you can write it on paper, you can write it on your computer, and some people just carry it in their heads. We actually recommend writing it either on paper or on your laptop. But a description of today's class plan is the lesson plan. The amount of detail in the lesson plan actually varies between instructor to instructor, topic to topic and so on. So some people do an outline, some do the entire class notes, they may have 10 pages of notes and they'll call it the lesson plan. Some have highlights and so on. So what we'll do in today's session is go through which details are actually useful in a lesson plan. In addition to those details, you can include several other details, there's no problem about it. But there are some details which are really important to be present in the lesson plan so that there is integration. And what do we mean by integration? It's the same triangle that we've been seeing for the last 8 weeks. That the three pillars, so to say, are the learning objectives, what the student should be able to do, the teaching learning activities, which include questions like what activities will I use in class, What resources are needed, what infrastructure is needed, what technology tools are needed. And the third point of this triangle is assessment. That is, how do I check students' understanding? And there's another piece here, which is how will students check their own understanding? So integration means taking all these three pieces which you have individually attained in the first 3 days, making sure that these two are aligned with each other, these two are aligned with each other, these are aligned with each other, and then putting it all together. That's your lesson plan. So before we actually proceed to the activity, let's do one quick discussion, mini discussion. So what I'd like you to do is brainstorm in your own centers which details or features are actually useful to include in a lesson plan. And we'll just do it as an open discussion. It's a small activity, so we won't do any formal thing per share, but we'll do it as a very quick open discussion. What I'd like you to pay attention is this integration. So if you say that I'm going to write details of the derivations of the theorem, that's not bad, but that's not the most important point. What you have to make sure is which details will make sure that the alignment and the integration is achieved. So in your centers, what you can do is just raise your hand and tell your coordinator which details are useful, and the coordinator maybe can summarize. So wait till you get 4 or 5 in your center, and then you can summarize it and send it over chat. And then we'll put it all together. So let's take about 2 minutes for this activity. Okay, so it looks like the answers have started coming in on chat, and most of you are saying the similar things and really the correct things that are needed for this integration. So you're saying that we need the learning objectives, the content. Somebody said we need the contents of the course. So the point is, we don't, in a lesson plan, typically we don't put the contents of the entire course, but it's about what are the topics and subtopics for that particular day. We also need the mode of teaching, that is which kind of activity for which subtopic. We need references, we need to put titles, some of you are saying time and so on. So okay, I think that's a good set. Most of you did get the point, and let's just summarize all of it. So in the lesson plan details, I think there is one part I missed out in this slide, I'll just correct it. We need that following details, and usually it's in this order. You can either make a table or you can just write it as a list, that we need the title of the lesson, we need the objectives, the learning objectives, we need some introduction here, and we need a list of which teaching learning activities are important. So okay, I think if you can stop sending it over chat, there are two or three important points I'd like to make on this slide. When we talk of teaching learning activities in the lesson plan, it's not enough to say I will do peer instruction, or it's not enough to say I will explain this concept. It's a much better idea if you have columns in your lesson plan or headings which say what does the teacher do, what does the student do, what do the students do, and which technology or resources are needed and how they're used for that particular topic or for that particular activity. The moment you have it separated like this, that this is what the teacher will do and this is what the students will do, then when you go to your class, the entire session will run as per schedule and as per the time. On the other hand, if you simply say I will explain the concept, it gets tricky, because will you explain it by giving a lecture, or will you show a demo, or will you show a demo with a peer instruction question? So get to that level of detail. You also need to put assessment questions in the lesson plan. I'm not the actual questions. Okay, what we mean here is we want to find out how students actually have understood this material. So it's a good idea to have one or two mini activities either in the middle or in the end, sometimes at the beginning of the next class, to check if students have actually understood. These sort of assessment questions or activities need not be graded. They are mainly for the teacher to check that the students have understood the material, and for the students to check for themselves, to do a self-assessment that these questions are actually, that they can actually answer these questions and they've actually understood the topic. Once the students answer the assessment questions, it's also a good idea to give some feedback to them. So these are quick, short duration assessment activities. It's not something that they'll write on a test and you'll grade it and get it back. It might be a quick peer instruction question in class where they get the feedback immediately. Or it can be a small diagram that they draw and you can have students do a peer review of each other's diagrams. So assessment questions, assessment activities in class for students to be able to check their own understanding, where they can also get feedback, is a good idea to include in your schedule. So it's a good idea to put it in your lesson plan. And there'll be a summary at the end of the activity, at the end of the session, and the time required per activity is usually a good idea to put it. Again, if you are a very experienced teacher, you have a rough idea anyway, but I take my lesson plan and somewhere on the side I write down that this activity will take 5 minutes and I'm budgeting 20 minutes for the other activity and so on. About these activities themselves, there is another point which is important to note. That students' attention span is pretty limited and it's definitely no more than 20 minutes. So what is recommended is that we mix up activities, we mix up different types of activities in a 1 hour class. And your lesson plan should reflect this, that perhaps you can do a 5 minute introductory lecture, then do a TPS activity for another 10 minutes. You can then resume a 15 minute lecture, then do a 1 minute assessment, then go back to lecture. So it's always a good idea to mix up the activities and make sure you're not staying on the same activity for more than 15 minutes. So in a 1 hour class, usually it means that you're switching activities at least 3 times. Sometimes people switch activities even more frequently, especially if you have smaller questions and so on. But don't say that I'm going to do a lecture for 45 minutes, then I'm going to give them a problem. It's much better if you do a 20 minute lecture, problem in between, another 20 minute lecture. Okay, so what are you going to do now? Firstly, you'll go to the lab after this session, in the next 5 minutes, and the lesson planning activity is uploaded on Moodle. Before that, before you go, what you should do is choose a partner from your domain. If you absolutely cannot find somebody, well, I guess you can do it individually also. So this activity is something which you will be using for your class. So it's good if you can find somebody and work with them, but otherwise it's okay if you do it as an individual activity if you can't find somebody. Together, choose a subject that you both are comfortable with, or choose a subject that you will be teaching next semester. Pick a topic in that subject that can be taught in one class. So scope it, narrow it down so that you pick a one class worth of topic. And then you can open the lesson plan worksheet. What is given in the lesson plan, there'll be a table given either in a spreadsheet or in a Word doc. There's a table really which has column headings for learning objectives. So you'll start by articulating the learning objectives of the course. Make sure you include at least one higher order learning objective. Don't keep all the objectives as students should be able to define or identify. Let there be at least one apply or analyze level or maybe even higher learning objective for that lesson. Write the teaching learning activities in order in that class, what the teacher will do, what the students will do. So all these points are there as columns in the activity. And you have to fill the template or the columns. In the teaching learning activity, again, make sure you don't do only lecturing. You don't say that I'll only lecture, because by now in the last 8 weeks, you've become familiar with several other active learning techniques. So do include at least some active learning strategies in your lesson plan, which have to be suitable for the objectives and for the topic. You can pick the same activities that you've written in the online homework and so on. So you can pick a topic for which you already have activities. That will work really well. Write the question. This is the activity. Get into detail, because we'd like to see your lesson plan and give you feedback and say what else is needed and so on. try to include at least some technology tool component. Especially after yesterday's sessions, both the morning lecture by Dr. Nina Thota and the afternoon session on wikis, the afternoon lab on wikis, now you have a handle on how to use technology tools in your classroom. And many of you know a lot of these technologies which are popular and in use. So use some technology tool component. It could be that you are going to show a visualization and do a peer instruction question after that. It could be that you do a peer instruction question that will ask students to predict the outcome of the visualization, then verify it in the visualization. So include a technology tool component and go beyond PowerPoint slides. So just because it says technology tool here, don't say that I'm going to show PowerPoint. So show PowerPoint and lecturing, go beyond it. I'm not saying don't do it at all, but try to go beyond it. Include an active learning strategy and include some technology tools. And write one or two questions for in-class assessment, either formative or summative. So this actually takes us to the lab session. What you can do is go to the lab, finish the lesson plan, then you can have tea and you reassemble here, let's say at 11:30 after tea. So in 1 hour, create this lesson plan. It's a good idea if you actually write details of the activities. In the sense, if you say you're doing a think pair share, don't simply say I'll do a think pair share. You say that I will do this think pair share and write the text of the question. If you say I'll show a visualization, write what's the topic, put the URL of the visualization, and say I'll show this visualization and I'll ask students to work on this question after the visualization. So get into detail so that the lesson plan is actually useful for you. Okay, so go to lab, do the lesson plan, go have tea and reassemble here at 11:30.